A reading from the letter of Paul the Romans. To him who can strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now is manifested in the prophetic writing and according to the command of God's eternal one, made known to all nations, to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, to Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul, writing from the prison of Caesarea Philippi prior to his visit to Rome, is trying to make known to his people that he is about to visit, that although they have been evangelized by the apostle Peter, talking about the people of Rome and those who have escaped from Jerusalem or from Palestine due to persecution of the early Christians, he is telling them that he is going to strengthen them by my gospel, that gospel that Jesus has revealed to him, that gospel that Peter has proclaimed to them, that gospel is going to bring salvation. That gospel, according to St. Paul, was a secret for thousands of years. But in time, it was revealed and manifested to the writings of the prophets, and according to the eternal God, was made known to us. We were obedient to the faith. And then he said, this faith that we are obedient to comes from a wise God who loved us so much that he wants us to return to love him, so that after we have loved him on the face of this earth and really do his bidding, we will be with him forever in the eternal world. We are a few days away from Christmas, to commemorate the great mystery of our faith, when God, in his love for us, sent his Son to be born like us, but sin. So that in this great mystery, we come to know that God has sent his Son for one reason, and that is to reconcile us with him, so that we who follow and accept him one day we'll do it him in heaven. My dear people, it's not Christmas that we celebrate, you know, with parties and running through to the malls and going from one place to another to prepare our gift for our loved ones. That really is all together what Christmas is all about. But to really understand, to let go of those things in our life that is hindering us to receive him in our heart. Because those days when he will come, not anymore an infant, but he come to be the judge of the living and the dead, will find us ready. So that our great welcome that we give him is the great joy that we receive in return. Because he who has called us and called us for this purpose, to come to know. And that sacred mystery of the old and be revealed to us through his Son. May the readings of tonight remind each one of us to deepen our love for God and to make us understand that the love that we have for him has to be manifested in the love that we have for those who walk the path of God.